Hello everyone, I am Anshika Lunia and I'm currently pursuing my bachelor's degree from the Acropolis Institute of Technology and Research in CSIT branch. The topic we are gonna cover up in this video I'll mention on the screen. So here the video begins with the introductory part. And the question arises as the what is the database architectures? A database architectures is a representation of the database design. The database architectures outlines how the data is organized, stored, and accessed within a database system, as well as how the system ensures the data integrity, availability, and security. It helps to design, develop, implement, and maintain the database management system. It involves making the decision about the layout of the data, the relationship between the different data elements, and the method used for the storing and the retrieving the data efficiency, and the mechanism in the place to handle the concurrent access by the multiple users of the processes. A database management system architectures allows dividing the database system into individual components that can be independently modified, changed, replaced, and altered. The database architecture is crucial for the designing and implementing the database system that met the requirement of the specific application while also ensuring the performance, scalability, and reliability. Now we will have the types of the database architectures, that is one tier, two tier, and three tier. Now the begins with one tier architectures. In the one tier architectures, the database, user interface, and the application logics all reside on the same machine or a server. It typically used for the small scale applications where simplicity and the cost effectiveness are prioritized, because there is no network delays involved, and this type of the tier is generally a fast way to access the data. From the example you can understand the one tier architectures would be a mobile application that uses a Realme, the open source mobile database by the MongoDB, as a local database. In this case, both the application and the database are running on the user's mobile devices. From the given diagram, we can understand on a single tier application, the application and the database reside on the same device. Now, the two-tier database architecture. Two-tier database architectures consisting of the multiple clients connecting directly to the database. This tier architecture is also known as client-server architectures. From the diagram, you can understand in a two-tier architectures, the clients are connecting directly to the database. For an example, in a house customer relationship management that connects to access data, right? The third tier database architecture. Most modern web applications uses a three-tier architectures. In the three-tier architectures, there is another layer between the client and the server. The client doesn't directly communicate with the server. Instead, it interacts with an application server, which further communicates with the database system, and the query processing and the transaction management takes place. This intermediate layer acts as a medium for the exchange of the partially processed data between the server and the client, and this type of the architecture is used in the case of the large web applications. In this architectures, the client connects to a data backend, which in turn connects to a database. From the example, you can understand an intermediate level layer that acts as a medium for the exchange of the partially processed data between the server and the client. Now the last topic, the three-level database architectures. This three-level database architecture consisting of the three layers. First, external level, second, conceptual level, and third is internal layer. Client tier, that is also called as presentation level, and external level. It is also known as view level. The reason this level is called as view is because the several users can view their desired data from this level, which is internally fetched from the database with the help of the conceptual and internal level mapping. The client area is responsible for the presenting the data to the users and capturing the user input. The external layer is the top level of the three-level database architecture. Now the middle tier, application tier, and also known as conceptual level and logical level. The whole design of the database, such as a relationship among the data, schema of the data, etc., are described in this level. The database constraints, the securities are also implemented in this level of the architectures. This level is maintained by the DBA, means database architect, database administrator. The third layer, that is data layer, database layer, or internal layer, or a physical layer. This level describes how the data is actually stored in a storage devices. This level is also responsible for the allocating the space to the data. This is the lowest level of the architectures. The common database system used in the data for the tier includes the relational databases, NoSQL databases, and others. Now we are binding up the topics. Thank you so much for your patience. Do like, subscribe, and press the bell icon. Thank you.